This video is brought to you by Sanebox. Stay tuned to learn more about how Sanebox can help you keep a decluttered inbox. Do you want more flexibility when it comes to presenting PowerPoint within Zoom? Or maybe you want to add a little pizzazz and impress the people that you're presenting to? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you three different ways that you can present Microsoft PowerPoint so you can see everything, your notes, your participants, and present the way you want to. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And let's get things started by jumping into our Zoom console. I've got a Zoom meeting started here already. And of course, probably the easiest way to share PowerPoint is just to share your entire screen, right? We can come down here to share. We can click on basic and say share screen, and we can just say share. Now I'm sharing my entire screen. Now in this case, I'm going to have to put myself into presentation view if I want to share my slides at this point. I can use my spacebar or my mouse or whatever I want to continue with the presentation. But the big drawback here is that I can't access anything else. If I need to go back, I'm showing people my slides here. If I need to go pull up some notes or another document, they're going to be seeing everything that I'm sharing here on my screen. So let's stop here for a second and show you three better ways and how to share PowerPoint. The first one I want to share with you has to do with just sharing the PowerPoint file or the PowerPoint application. So if we click on share here, instead of selecting share screen, as in your entire desktop, we want to come down here and actually find the PowerPoint application. If we select this and hit share, it's true. At this point, they are seeing this preview pane here within PowerPoint. However, if I was to click on my browser here, for example, if I'm here to click on something else within my computer, no one else is seeing that. They're only going to be seeing what I have here within my PowerPoint presentation. Again, I'm going to have to go into slide mode here if I want to show it in full screen as I'm going through my presentation. But at least in this case, I know that anything else that I click on, they are only going to see what's happening here in PowerPoint. But let's take it one step further. And the second tip I want to give you here is that you can actually present in presenter mode here within PowerPoint. Now, number one, you want to make sure that you're only sharing the PowerPoint application for this to work. Now, I can go into my slide view again, and again, you're probably very familiar with this view. But if we come down to the left-hand side and click the More button, we can go into the Show Presenter view. Now, some of you may be familiar with this view already, especially if you're used to working with dual monitors or perhaps hooking up your computer to a projector, such as in a live scenario. However, what's important to note is that when you're using Zoom, only the slides itself, only what we see here on the left-hand side is actually being shown to people on Zoom. So we get all the benefits of PowerPoint presenter view. We can use the arrow keys down below here. We can see a preview of the next slide in the top right-hand corner. And although I don't have many notes here on this particular slide deck, if I did, they would all be visible to me, but they're not visible to my Zoom participants. So this can be a great way to present online. Only my Zoom participants are seeing this screen here. I can see the preview, I can see my notes, and confidently go through the rest of my presentation. Now, there's another one that we want to look at as well, and that has to do with, let me get out of my presentation view here for a second. I know for many of you, you may want to access your notes which are not included within PowerPoint. Maybe you have a separate file, maybe you want to be referencing something else, maybe you just need to be doing a few things off the side as you're presenting a PowerPoint slide deck. Well, here within PowerPoint, if we go to the slideshow menu, and then we come here to say set up slideshow, we have an option here called show type. Now, by default, it's going to be presented by a speaker. It calls this a full screen view. But if you want to access other pieces of information on your screen while only showing your viewers your slide deck, you can choose this second one, which is called browsed by an individual, meaning that it's actually going to just pop up in an individual window. If I select this and say okay, and now if I launch the presenter view, you, what I can do is I can actually minimize this and I can resize this window if I need to. I can drag this over here to the left-hand side, and then I can have other things going on my screen. I can pull up other applications. Let me minimize this Word document just as an example. So let's say that I have all my notes over here. I can access this. Maybe I want to view the chat window here on the side of my screen. I can permanently have that open there, and I'm not obstructing anyone else's views, and they're not seeing my whole screen either. All they are seeing is this window here, which you can see is encapsulated by this green color. Now, the one thing of note is that it will also share the header, which is going to show the title of your PowerPoint slide, and it's also going to show the total number of slides and these navigation options down below. So you can either choose these arrow keys. You can still use the arrow keys on your keyboard or the space bar on your keyboard to navigate and advance through your slides, but you can access your notes over here. You can take a look at other things that are going on in your screen, and all they are going to see is this window here. So this can be really helpful for those of you who want to take advantage of other applications on your screen without sharing everything else. Remember, the key in this particular example is that you have to share only the PowerPoint application first when you hit that share button, and then you can choose this option within PowerPoint. Let me hit stop share here for just a second, and I want to show you perhaps the most powerful way and the most impressive way of sharing PowerPoint here within Zoom. Recently, Zoom has introduced a brand new feature which is really impressive and actually puts you in front of your slides. So let me show you how it works. Once again, we want to come down here and select the share button, but instead of staying on the basic tab, we want to come over here to the advanced tab and select PowerPoint as a virtual background. Now in this case, once we hit the share button, we're actually going to have to go and find the file itself. It's not like just sharing your screen or sharing the PowerPoint application. I do need to go and find the PowerPoint presentation that I want. I'm going to select open, and then Zoom is not only going to load it right here within my meeting, but as you can see, I am now in front of my slides. So I don't have to see, or I don't have to question if my participants can see me, if they've minimized my view. I can ensure if I'm sharing my PowerPoint slides, I'm right here in front of them. And I can continue to navigate through all of my slides just as I normally would. Now there's a few different options you have here. I can click on my image, and actually I can move it anywhere I want. So if I'm on a particular slide and my image is actually in the way of something, I can move it. If I want to resize myself, maybe I want to make myself a little smaller, put myself in the bottom left-hand corner, I can do that as well. Now I can continue to navigate by selecting these arrow keys down below, but the other important thing is if I get to a slide like this where, you know, there's already a picture of me, what I can do is select these three dots and say split video from PowerPoint. So that's going to remove my overlay. It's going to remove my video on top of this slide. And then perhaps when I navigate to my next slide where I do want to be front and center, I come here again, and this time I'm going to select merge video and PowerPoint. Here I am again. Maybe I need to make myself a little bit bigger just so I draw people's attention, and I can continue on with this presentation. This can be a fantastic way to not only engage your audience, but make sure that they're seeing you at the same time that you're presenting these slides. A tip would be that you want to make sure that you, number one, know your slides very well, and perhaps that you have a lot of your written content, for example, a little adjusted to one side of the slide. So you're not always having to go and click and drag yourself and resize your window. That may be a little both confusing, a little nauseating for some of your viewers as well, but this can be a really effective and impressive way to present PowerPoint via Zoom. Now, if you'd like to keep your email inbox in order, check out Samebox. Samebox is the artificial intelligent tool to help you keep your inbox and all of your messages uncluttered. I especially love the Sane Later folder, which learns from you as you move different messages into the folder. Therefore, you don't have to fill up your inbox with things that you don't need to see right away. And the great thing about Samebox is that it learns from your behavior. So the more that you use it, the better it gets at refining your messages. If you'd like to try Samebox for yourself and receive a special bonus just for Simpletivity viewers, be sure to click the link in the description below.